Good afternoon, everybody, and you're very welcome once again to our weekly lunchtime concert. Today I'm delighted to welcome Liam Lawton, my colleague and very, very good friend he's from County Offaly, from Edenderry, but he currently lives just about in County Laois, down in Greg Cullen Parish. And he's accompanied today by Maria Quinn and Julianne Woods. And Liam has been here many times before. Normally when this church is packed to capacity, one of our Christmas concerts over the last few years. Today is a slightly different experience. But anyway, Liam, I'm so delighted that you're here, and Maria and Julianne, and thank you very much for coming.
Thanks, Martin, and good afternoon to everybody. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to introduce you to a couple of the songs that I've written over the years. The first piece that we're going to hear is a piece from what is called the Valley of the Saints, or otherwise known as Glen de Loch. And I wrote this having been there. I go there, I live about 45 minutes from Glen de Loch, and if you've never been there, put it on your to-do list. But whenever you go there, the light is constantly changing. And for nearly 1,500 years, people have been going there seeking peace, healing, wisdom, or a sense of God. This is called In the Quiet. Thank you.
I am family.
first collection that I had out was Oscailge. I love the Irish language. I'll speak a little bit more about that later on. But so the first collection was a collection called Malasha, and it was dedicated to a man called Lazarian, who was the first saint in South Leinster. So I wrote a mass for him, and included was a psalm called Magrohu Ahirna, My Lord, My Love, My Rock. And it became very popular, so people were asking me about translating it. But I felt that to translate something directly from Irish would ruin them. So I wrote an English setting, a different one, called The Hiding Place. And I'm delighted to have sing with me Julianne Woods. Julie is a teacher in Haywood, in the community college there, but is an accomplished musician herself. And she's here playing the harp, but she's going to sing for you now. Both versions of Hiding Place and McGraw.
Quiet, Lord, I pray.
Thanks, Julie. The next piece, I was asked to write for a wedding. And the couple who were getting married were courting for years and years and years and years and years. So you get the picture. Anyway, the night before the wedding, the groom's mother died. And that made the song even more poignant because they kept giving me instructions as to writing the song. And it was to memorize both their fathers who had died. Now the groom's mother had died. So the song became even more important. So the song memorizes or takes, I suppose when I go into a place, a beautiful church like this, or to any place, we remember all those who have gone before us. Those who prayed here in the seats, those who received the sacraments here, and those who left here on their final farewell as they go to be buried. And so it says that wherever there is a gathering, that there is a place for all our loved ones. There is a place.
For you.
So I said earlier that I love the Irish language. So my father comes from a Brat Gaeltacht, and he came to work in the Midlands where he met my mother. And so I grew up in a home that was had a great love of the Irish language, of things, culture, and the cred of this Gacrod Marsin. So in this is a piece that I'm going to sing in Gaelic. And it honors one of the great Irish poets of the 18th century, that was Tadhg Eolach Ó Sualainn. He wrote at the end of the penal times. There's a very interesting story about him, that he was a satirist, and he wrote a lot of cynical poetry against the government at the time during the penal days. And he used to go, he was a wandering bard, and he was paid by the household and put up for a few days, and then he would wander on. So he found himself in Waterford and along the quays, and he went in one night to a tavern, and sitting alongside him was a man who began chatting with him. And the man was none other than Edmund Ignatius Rice. And they became close friends, and he had an influence on Tadhg Eolach Ó Sualainn, so much so that he had a conversion in his life. And he gave us then some of the most beautiful religious poetry written in the 18th century. So I wanted to honor that relationship. Unfortunately, Tadhg Eolach fell in bad times, and he died one day on the steps of the Cathedral of Waterford. He was buried in a pauper's grave. He was penniless when he died. And yet, he was one of the great, great poets of this era. So as I said, this piece is called Magrosumir or Alalu, and so I've taken the verses from Tadhg Eolach Ó Sualainn and I wrote a refrain and the music around them. So this, here we go. This is recorded by Brian Kennedy for me a couple of years ago.
Hallelujah, 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 Lord,
So the next piece is very, very different. In the year 2000, the relics of St. Therese of Lisieux were brought to Ireland. And they travelled right throughout the countryside. And I was involved in the coming of the relics to Dublin. And so I was asked to write a piece of music. So I wrote a piece of music which is based on the poetry of Therese of Lisieux. Many people didn't realize that she wrote much poetry. So this is called Journey of a Soul. Traditions and some of the customs that were prevalent in our society. And there's always been a great reverence in the Irish tradition for angels. In fact, the word angel in Irish is angel, which comes from two words, ein gial, which translated means the bright place. So there was a belief that the angels came from the bright place, which of course is a pseudonym for heaven. There was always the tradition that, and the belief that every beautiful church like this, every parish, every heart of the home, and every human heart was guided by an angel, that there was an angel particularly for each parish and each church. One of the great traditions, or one of the, I suppose, well, what you might call it, one of the customs was that if somebody was going out on a dark night, the head of the household would take a piece of burnt ember from the fire, and this is in the days long before electricity, etc., and take a piece of burnt ember from the fire as a symbol of the angel, the burnt ember, because it's from the bright place. So, carrying on in this tradition, I wanted to honor the presence of my own guardian angel. So I wrote a piece called The Voice of an Angel, which Julianne, the voice of an angel, is now going to sing for you.
Come to
Thanks, Julie. It's a gorgeous acoustic in this church, so it lends itself to that kind of song. When I started ministry in Carlow, I was asked one day if I would bring Holy Communion to an elderly lady, and she was in the area that I was working in, and so I was supposed to bring it to her every month, but in fact started going every week, and I really, really loved her. Her name was Essie Purcell, and she was one of the founder members of Fianna Fáil. She was one of the founders of Cumann na mBan, and the day she left her cell in Kilmainham Jail, Eamon de Valera went into it. So in 2016, when we celebrated the 100 years of the 1916 rising, there was a beautiful garden opened in Carlow in memory of it, and I was asked if I would do a piece in commemoration for this. And so one day, years ago, I got a phone call. It was a Sunday afternoon, saying, "Are you there?" And I said, "Yeah, it's you, Essie." And she said, "Yeah, can you come down?" So I went down anyway, and she said, "I'm going home this evening." And I looked around and said, "But you are at home." And she said, "No, I'm going home. Home. And I'd like to hear my confession. Would you celebrate my funeral?" And I did, and she died that evening. And she talked all about life as it was during those times. She was a great, lovely, lovely lady. So I'd like to remember her now in this piece, which I've called Dare to Dream. And it's really about if the people who signed the 1916 proclamation and the people who died for Ireland and fought for Ireland, if they could reimagine what kind of an Ireland we would have today, would they be happy? There's a place I know. In my dreams I go to a valley fair, so wild and green, where the tall trees grow and the rivers flow, where freedom lies, oh yeah. There's a tree that towers in a shady bough, and it stands so strong against the storm, where its roots are firm and its branches cling to the light. Skylark soars neath Atlantic shores, with her song of freedom, song of liberty. Because of COVID-19, and it's played havoc in many, many lives. But there have been many, many tributes paid to the frontline workers, and rightly so. But I've also been thinking about the people who have been in hospital and who've been unable to see their loved ones, been unable to hold their hands, to see them, particularly when they pass from this life. A friend of mine spent 3 hours in a car park gazing at the window in the hospital where her father was dying on the other side. And so this piece commemorates such people, and it also tells us that we're not alone, that God has promised to be with us at all times, and I honestly believe that. So for all the people who have lost someone, for all the people who have loved ones in hospital and can't get to see them, please remember, you're not alone. Though you're on your own, So we've come to the last song, which I'm delighted to be here. Thank you so much, Father Martin and Maureen, for looking after us and to be able to take part in your Tuesday concerts. Thank you especially as well to Maria Quinn there on piano, to Julianne Woods behind me here on the harp. Julianne is going to help me in the last song. So the last song that we're going to sing for you, by the way, I know also that there are many people watching in from this locality, but also I mentioned Catherine Ryan from Great Cullinan Carlow watching. I know Sarah Lawler is watching from London, and I want to mention those especially. Anyway, you can go back now and have your dinner. So this last song, I suppose it means a lot to me, but I had a mentor, an uncle who was mine, who was very close to me and was a musician, and he used to mentor me also, and I was about to do two concerts with him, and he was killed tragically in a car accident, with a young family as well, so it was a difficult time. So I was teaching down in Carlow in Knockbeg College at the time, and for about 6 weeks afterwards, I was going around with this great cloud. I wasn't interested in music, I wasn't interested in singing, I wasn't interested in anything. And it was the first kind of tragedy that we had met within our family, and it was very difficult. So one day, this lady who was in one of the choirs that I worked with sent me a card that she had made herself. And simply, there was just a line across the front of the card, which was taken from an old prayer in Kerry, which simply said, "And when the dark clouds veil the sky, remember, I'm still there." And it was exactly how I felt walking around this grey cloud, but it was a catalyst for me to sit down and write a piece. And I actually sat down that night and wrote this piece of music. And we used it in the choir, and we recorded it. And so then, roll on a couple of years, and I went to Limerick, as did the girls here, to do my master's. And one day, coming back from Limerick, I got a phone call from the publishers, and it was the day after 9/11, saying that the images that were coming through on the television of all these clouds of ash from the buildings falling were exactly like as was seen in the song, the words of the song, "The dark clouds veil the sky." And so they asked me if I would allow it to be downloaded, and I, of course I did. And so that was a Tuesday, and on the Friday there was the National Memorial Service in America for 9/11, and this piece was sung at it. And it was sung in New York. And so what happened was that many of the fire officers and many of the police officers were present there, and they asked for it at the funerals of their loved ones. The first one to die in 9/11 was a man called Michael Judge, who was chaplain to the fire brigade, and so to sung then, and so that's why a lot of the police officers wanted it then to be sung whenever somebody they knew was killed as well. So this was the piece. So then it was picked up by the army, and anybody, particularly in one battalion, anyone that was going in to Iraq, received a copy of the words of this piece of music, the little crossover as well. But this is very significant for me. It's called Clouds Veil. Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the hills, even when the dark clouds fill the sky, you are by my side. Even when the sun shall fall asleep, even when at dawn the sky shall weep, even in the night when stars shall rise, you are by my side. God is by my side. Bright the stars at night, heaven's way to you. Bright the stars in light, with love is faith in love and true. Even though the rain hides the stars, even though the mist swirls the even when the dark clouds fill the sky, you are by my side. Even when the sun shall fall and sleep, even when at dawn the sky shall weep, even in the night, you are by my side. God is by my side.
Keep the feast of God, when saints shall gather in deep peace.
Once again, a lovely, lovely concert, Liam. Lovely, absolutely lovely. And I've had the pleasure of sitting in the church for most of them, and the atmosphere in the church and the sound in the church is absolutely wonderful. We had a message from Roseanne in Florida, who says she's loving the music, and she remembers listening to Liam's music when she approached Glenda Locke for the first time on her last trip to Ireland. And also, what you probably don't know is we have a connection to New York and the firefighters who helped in 9/11. Lieutenant Eddie Meehan was on Ladder 22 in Manhattan. He's a cousin of my own, a distant cousin. But his son Emmett has since joined the firefighters in New York as well. So we remember Eddie fondly. He died, I think last year it was, from an illness he contracted as a result of 9/11. So he and all of the others are fondly remembered. Once again, to Maria and to Julianne and to Liam, thank you very much. Next week, we have Valerie Casson from Abbey Leaks and our own Christy Phelan, who will come and join us on Tuesday next at 1 o'clock. So we thank you again for the wonderful entertainment, and we know that everybody out there has loved it. Thank you very much. Thank you.